Hi, my name is Meg Edwards and I'm a GTD coach. And many times when I'm working with a client, they're very curious to know what I personally use to track my projects and actions and someday maybes, et cetera. And how do I use it? And I'm always happy to show them. But one of the things that we do as GTD coaches is we help clients figure out what is the best tool for them to use and what is the best way for them to use it. So I'm going to go ahead and continue the conversation about how I use OmniFocus. The last video I did was how I use OmniFocus to capture and clarify and organize things that are actionable that I'm going to put on my project and next actions list, and also how I track my project plans or project support or future actions of things that I want to attach to my projects. Today, what I wanted to do was share with you how I use OmniFocus to track those things that kind of go on the no side of the clarifying and organizing map. So basically, that really has to do with the incubate and reference. Not everything is actionable, and it is so easy if you don't have a home on the no side or the maybe side. So if it's a maybe, it still goes on the no side. And I know in the beginning, when I didn't have the buckets that I needed to incubate and reference, I just made everything an action and project. And then the list got really big and overwhelming. So if somebody told me a book that they recommended, I would add that to my next actions list. Or if there was a movie or anything, a restaurant or to visit, I was always making it an action because I didn't know where else to put it. So I just wanted to show you how over the years I've really expanded the no side of this clarifying and organizing map. So that being said, let me go ahead and share my OmniFocus with you again. So what I have set up here is I have set up electronic Tickler, and I track my someday maybes here. So this has to do with the things that the distinction I make for the Tickler is it's attached to a time. It's like a mailer to myself. And so at the beginning of every month, I come into my Tickler. So we're in March, we're at the end of March, but in the beginning of the March, I come into my Tickler. And either I do things right off the bat off of my Tickler, particularly if it's a 2-minute rule, or I schedule time to do that. I just copy it over into a tag. So for example, at the beginning of March, I needed to schedule time to run my generator. I needed to schedule time to do some shopping for Annie. I needed to call the vets and call to get my snow tires off and my bike tune up. Those things I really can do in less than 2 minutes, and I just go ahead and do it. I understand how OmniFocus, you can do things on the defer and due dates and all that kind of stuff. I choose not to use those features. I don't mean that they don't work and they can't be really useful. I just have too much nuance for me, or I like too much nuance, that I find that I like to just have a flat list to then decide what I want to do with it. But I understand all the features. I shouldn't say all, but I understand enough of the features of OmniFocus of how you could do that differently. But again, the purpose of these videos is not to teach you how to use OmniFocus, but just to share with you how I use it. I also recently, literally just started this Tickler for cooking. I am somebody who lives in Maine. And I know that there are apps for this, but I really am liking this where, for example, in July, I may be at the farmer's market and I may come across green tomatoes. And where are all those recipes for green tomatoes? And so I'm starting to just populate this now so that I can go and buy them and know all the recipes. So this is just something I'm playing around with. Then I have my someday maybe list. Now I am 60 years old now. If you looked at my someday maybe list, you know, when I was in my 30s or even 40s, it was much bigger. But my someday maybe list are those things that I want to look at pretty much, you know, every so often in my weekly review to decide if I want to make them active now. There's no time to it. if there's something that's kind of attached to a time, it might go on my goals or vision list. But basically, this doesn't have a time frame to it. So I just have some random someday maybes that I have that I like to track. And then I have reference. I have 5 reference folders. That might be overkill for some, you know, some people. Again, people have different cognitive preferences. And so this may be too split out for some people. But again, for me, I just like to have them separated that way. And it's just things that I'd like to have at hand. In OmniFocus, my deeper reference is in Evernote. How do I make that distinction between Omni and Evernote? I just kind of know when something is deeper archival reference. I mean, I recently scanned a trip that I took with my dad to Antarctica in 95. I don't need that here. And so I just have a notebook in Evernote that has everything from that trip scanned. And so it's just deeper reference that I have that. And for work, I use Google Docs and other things. So again, I just always had to decide what did I want to have here. A lot of times it's because I also just want to have it on my phone. The other thing that I have here is I have a folder for checklists. And these are just things that I have created again over the years that I have just needed. The funny one for me is I have a travel checklist. But the funny one for me is when my kid was going abroad, and I'm like, Annie, like, did you call the bank to let them know that you're going abroad? And what about medical? And do you need to go to the dentist? And I thought, this is not going to be the only time this kid's going to go abroad. And so I created this checklist. I mean, that's how things get created, right? And I literally just created, you know, all of these things that as mom, I'm still monitoring for Annie. She probably doesn't appreciate that I'm sharing this with her because she'll probably watch this video. But again, this is just things that just show up that then I go ahead and create it. I don't create stuff until it shows up. Otherwise, it's just noise, for at least for me. Then I have a folder called lists. This is where I put when somebody says, hey, you know, you might want to read this book or you might want to check out this movie or, you know, here's a new mocktail that you might want to try. Or I have a list of quotes. I think I want to start a record collection again. And these are records that I might want to buy. These are courses that I might want to take. These are teas that I drink. Again, they're just a bunch of lists. What's the difference between a list and a someday maybe and reference? It's just all nuanced. A list is just something that I have like literally a list of books, but is it a someday maybe book I want to buy? Yes, is it could be, but it's not reference. So again, these are just something that I have just organically kind of figured out over the years that works for me in terms of how I want to track things that are non-actionable right now. And then I have a next time in, which are places that I visit. And so, for example, you know, next time I'm in Boston, do I want to visit Leslie? You know, are there some clients I might want to reach out to? Do I want to stay at that hotel again or those restaurants? I am notoriously horrible at remembering things. So I love to be able to have a home for those things that I want to track in those cities. And so that is basically how I use the project section, which is for those things that not only track my projects, but are also for those things that I want to capture that are on the no side of the workflow clarifying and organizing map. And as I shared in the beginning, I needed to have all of these because I do like to track those things. And so I love how OmniFocus gives me that ability to expand my reference into the project section. So I hope, again, you found that this was helpful. I appreciate in the last video how people had talked about how simple I had used OmniFocus. I think that what I find with any tool is that if you can really break it down into its bare, most simplistic way of tracking your commitments personally and professionally, Then you can add all the fabulous features that they have. But do you have just the basics in place? And I find that when I'm working with clients and I share this with them, they're like, oh, I see how I can strip it down to its most basic entity and then build on it as you want to add those features that are going to help it make, executing and prioritization much more efficiently and effectively for you.